We are about to get the new season of GP2 underway. The cars are on the grid, 22 of them at least, and a very quick change. Away they go, and a good start from Romain Grosjean. Bruno Senna not so quick away, but we've got to look for Suchet, Chandak, Vales, Filippi. Look at the yellow car, that's the DPR machine, and that has come a long way up the grid. That's Andy Suchet, rather, in third place, from third on the grid. Diving in front, Karen Chandak, the top iSports driver, with Bruno Senna in second. Chandak, though, down in fifth position as they go through the first couple of corners now. Gareth, there was a very mixed set of weather conditions with the staller Ho Pin Tung, by the way, with heavy rain as well as a lot of sand on the track. The sand is still there. The rain, though, seems to have disappeared over the last couple of days. It's dry. Suchet up into second ahead of Senna. Now, the Spaniard, he's a 2006 Spanish Formula 3 champion, very 2005, very quick boy indeed. And this is on board with Adrian Vales for SMS. He gets bumped out by a Supernova car, which will be... That's Valerian, is that going by him? Sebastian Buemi. Well, Buemi and Bonanomi. That's the battle for second. Grosjean with Suchet in second, Bruno Senna in third, QI Meritus driver Luca Filippi. Now, he is toted by many people as being a likely champion. He's in fourth place at the moment. Enough of the turbulence as well. Ooh, this is good. Diving down the inside, well, around the outside, Kamui Kobayashi. Wow, that's a great move.
That was brave.
That was brave indeed. Kobayashi certainly not hanging around and very confident in his tyres. Went around Khan for 19th place. Sebastian Grosjean comes back out of the pits. The race leader here in Dubai in the opening round of the GP2 Asia Series. And the man who was in second as well, Andy Suchet, has stopped. That's the yellow car of Suchet in the background. So Romain Grosjean has, or the ART team, have done a great job of putting Grosjean very firmly back out in front. No slip-ups from them at all. Take halfway, I should think, probably not even at Central, maybe when we get to the Formula One support races before the rookies have even got half the handle on these cars that they need to be able to challenge guys that have raced them before.
Yeah, apart from Grosjean, he's not doing... Oh, Grosjean's just taken Fais's lap. Well, fantastic. Now, that just goes to show he's got a bit in hand, doesn't it?
Wow, that's half a second quicker than the previous. Yeah. Like 0.3 seconds.
He's been quite happy doing low 23. He suddenly gets pipped by Bonanomi and then bang, 22. Well, just to take back Fais's lap.
That has suddenly got to be a very big worry for everybody else, hasn't it?
Well, both today for the remainder of this series, but also...
Oh, that's... Here we go, Senna's on the inside.
It's a left-hander coming up, though. Yeah.
That's the first.
But he's on the back foot now. He's on the back foot. So down the long straight here, Senna could actually be in with a chance.
That is the first time he's got alongside. And there's four laps after this. So Suchet in the middle, defending hard.
Around the outside.
Senna goes around the outside.
Careful,
Suchet,
boys.
Not got the grip. He hasn't.
Now he's done him.
He has a better chance for tomorrow because he's in eighth place at the moment and 6 seconds ahead of Firouz Fawzi. So unless Fawzi produces something exceptional, Chandak will start tomorrow's race first. But the winner of the first race of the GP2 Asia Series, as we finally catch the leader in traffic, is Romain Grosjean. Pole position and victory in his first ever outing in a GP2 car. And the maiden GP2 Asia race goes to Romain Grosjean and the ART team. So the French combination triumphant again. Bruno Senna takes second place. Andy Suchet in third. Here with Luca Filippi, the Meritus driver. Fifth place for Meritus in their first race. So for the first time, it is an all-Asian front row. Hiroki Yoshimoto, third from Japan. Fourth man on the grid will be Luca Filippi, the Italian. Fifth, Adrian Vales. And sixth, Andy Suchet with second place yesterday. Bruno Senna and race winner Romain Grosjean in seventh and eighth positions. And as the teams watch ready for the start of the race, everybody who was out there has made it onto the grid. We're missing Nunes and Khan. They'll start from the pit lane if at at all. And again, a slow getaway by Karen Chunduk from the far side of the track as we looked at it there, the dirty side. And look at the filth being spread, that white car on the left-hand side. That's Roman Grosjean with Andy Suchek in the yellow machine just closing his nose off. And Grosjean, despite getting a very good getaway, has gone backwards. And the Supernova car of Fauzi has been passed for the lead. We're with Filippi there. And who's gone around the outside?
I think it's Vales.
Vales, yes. From the fifth position on the grid. So it's despite the fact he was on the dirty side and didn't look to have got the greatest start, he found a hole. It is Adrian Vales that leads further back. That's Stephen Jelly being forced off onto the dirt. Well, it's going to be all arms and elbows in the first lap here with Kamiya Kobayashi, his dam's teammate, on the inside of him as he goes around the outside. And that's Vales gone off, I think.
Yes, right. It is.
And so it's Fauzi that leads now. Filippi in second place. Light still on the safety car. No. Filippi has pulled off. Look at his, see the fingers? Flick, flick, flick. He's got no gears. It's died. He's got an engine and he's got no gears. And that, well, I was just about to say my money is on him to make the best stab at the restart. I mean, Fauzi is really a sitting duck as the leader, isn't he? Because although he sort of dictates the pace, he's the only man who doesn't know what the car, what the other cars are doing. But that's it, Filippi is out. I mean, he's flicking left, right and centre, trying to get the thing to engage a gear.
So it's given up.
But you're right. I mean, that, you know, that's one of the things of having a really bright strobe bar across the roof of the car is that it gives more than just one driver a clue. He is in.
Yep.
So here we go. Fauzi nails it quickly. And with Yoshimoto in second place behind him, I think Fauzi has got the lead here. Yoshimoto has got a good run onto the straight. Karen Chunduk third has got Roman Grosjean, yesterday's winner, close behind him. Fifth place is Alberto Valerio in the Durango car. Expect to see Grosjean pulling out. Well, Yoshimoto more in the hope of something happening. And yes, Grosjean right down the inside. And exactly as you mentioned, Gareth, very aggressive. That was on the cards right from the moment he came onto the straight.
Yeah, it was an excellent move. I mean, he didn't want to get into a situation that Senna did yesterday, being stuck behind someone for lap after lap. So he just took his chance, bang, first corner, and coming through.
Replay of the start again, or the restart.
It's just turning up behind Chunduk, isn't it, and down the inside. See, Chunduk kind of made a half-hearted effort to kind of cover that move. He saw it coming.
Yep.
But Grosjean was through.
Chunduk got onto the brakes and had a little weave, as you say. And in fact, it wasn't until then that Grosjean made up the ground on him. It was by not being on the brakes. I thought he'd towed up a lot closer than that. But the onboard showed again that the straight is not long enough to really get, not that Monza slipstream launch that you get.
Yeah, no, it was definitely Grosjean being braver on the brakes, but also being braver on cold tyres, really.
Yep.
And Chunduk, with his experience yesterday of spinning the car twice, was just being a little bit too careful.
Very highly touted, Tung, but has yet to really produce the goods at anything like this level. Well, Grosjean again taking different lines. Now, Gareth, is that a factor of trying to phase Yoshimoto or just trying to find a quicker way of getting around those corners?
I thought that was a slight mistake then, actually. I thought he just missed his apex by going in slightly too deep.
Well, that was option C. But he's now perfectly placed. Look how close he is on the straight. Now, that is a proper passing place. Yoshimoto moves over to cover.
That's it, get back online, force the guy inside, get hard on the power. Really had that covered.
Yes, he certainly did, didn't he? Despite the fact he went in deep and flat, Yoshimoto actually got off the corner better.
He did very well, yeah.
Mm. And again, that shows how the spectre of having a big lose on cold tyres is very much uppermost in everybody's minds. And Chunduk having a very good look there at Yoshimoto.
Yeah, so Grosjean's moved
Grosjean
up to second,
has
hasn't he?
Gone by, yes. Yep. Grosjean moved up to second. Yeah, so Fauzi now will have to start minding his P's and Q's because Roman Grosjean has got by Hiroki Yoshimoto and Karen Chunduk nearly did there as well. Aha, there you go. It was the pit lane exiting Schlegelmilch that blocked Yoshimoto inadvertently. But Grosjean, again, just saw the gap open up. Thank you, God. And straight through he went. And now he is latched onto Fauzi. So again with Grosjean. Feroz Fauzi right in front. And Fauzi in too deep. Watching the mirrors, Gareth, again. Well, he made that too easy,
didn't he? Wasn't it?
Yeah, well, I tell you what. Never mind who's going to win the GP2 Asia Series. Suddenly, we've got a new name throwing his hat into the arena for the main series. Roman Grosjean, the others are going to be going, OK, tell me, please, this isn't going to be another Lewis Hamilton year, is it?
It's a replay from outside the car from the other angle.
Yeah.
As you say, just goes in too deep, watching his mirrors. Almost lets him pass, doesn't he? Yeah, you're right. It marks him out as a serious championship contender. I mean, bear in mind, Senna was pre-season one of the favourites for 2008. And so far, he's really struggled to match Grosjean's pace. I think it marks Grosjean out as one of, if not the men to watch, because my other choice for this year was Philippe. I think he might do a good job, but... Grosjean is making both of them look a bit slow at the moment.
Obviously, iSports, you would expect iSports' faster driver to be Senna, and he hasn't quite got the experience that Grosjean has, although he has got more experience of these cars at this level.
Yeah, that's a good point, actually, isn't it? I mean, although Senna has this will be his second year in GP2 and Grosjean's first. I mean, Grosjean's been racing a long, long time in karts and Formula Renault, Formula 3, so he's worked his way up the single-seater ladder, winning it every turn. I think if you look at his career stats, he's won something like 25% of all the races he's competed, which is a staggering statistic, really.
Well, this is Grosjean's 112th race. This is Senna's 85th.
Yeah.
So Senna started racing in 2004. Grosjean was already in the Formula Renault Euro Cup. He started karting, back in in the late 90s.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you're right. And he has won nearly 30% of all the races.
Nearly 27%. Yeah, that's incredible. I mean, that is incredible.
Absolutely.
Clearly a very talented lad. And he's going to give Senna and the rest and his teammate Philippe a hard time this year.
And it's not gone unnoticed because by winning several Renault championships and starring in several Renault championships, he's brought himself to the notice of the men at Viry-Châtillon, who are always looking for a quick Frenchman. And he has a Renault Formula 1 test contract as well, which he'll be trying to combine with GP2 Asia and GP2's main series, as well as claiming his second race victory in his race rookie weekend. Now, when was the last time somebody did a clean sweep? I haven't got that one to hand. We have had a few, haven't we? A clean sweep of pole, a race one and race two victory. But I think, do I remember correctly, there's been less than six. That's an impressive effort by Romain Grosjean. His first race weekend at this level. He hasn't done World Series. He hasn't done 3000 of any kind. He's come in from Formula 3. That is mighty impressive effort indeed by Romain Grosjean.